welcome to Angie's Creative Studio. I'm Angie. Today we are going to do a watercolor of cowboy rates and a cowboy hat. And I am using the Paul Rubens hot press block for this. And like I said, in a couple videos, somebody sent this to me, and I really do appreciate whoever sent it. I don't know who it was, they didn't say. And I just want to say thank you. I have drawn on this, so I'm going to erase. I was using the projector copy pad, and I really screwed up. So I'm going to center this just like so, and I've done this like I normally would, because it's just easier for me. I'm going to use a piece of painter's tape, and like most of y'all know by now, I get my painter's tape at Dollar Tree. I am going to break into this new carbon paper and get a sheet out. Well, I say a sheet and I get everything else out. And for the ones that don't know, my son moved back home last couple weeks ago, so my life has just went hectic. And we've moved him into our 32-foot travel trailer and bought a 34-foot Class 8. Pray tell me that one. But anyways, with that being said, we're remodeling the Class A, so that's where I've been. So that's why there ain't no videos been out. Okay, I'm just gonna trace this lightly with my pencil. And we've got all kinds of background noise because of remodeling the RV and a building being built and whatnot. And believe it or not, this is all outside. So how's everybody's week going? Okay. Hold on. Try this. Next darker. Yep, can y'all see how dark that is? Look. I did not aim to do it that dark, but yes, I've been using that one. It's just green. But I'm getting fresh one. I am using my new My paint. And I'm gonna just mess these with the water bottle. And now I'm going in to find me a brush. And y'all, I may be interrupted a dozen times because my son, thanks. He just walks in. So, if that happens, I'm sorry. We are trying to teach him that he's 18 and, you know. He forgets mama videotapes. Because usually mama don't videotape when he's around. But, anyways, I'm going in with Bon Import and something brown. Mixing it to make my hat the color I want. And you can use black, you can use brown, you can use whatever color you want for this. You can use blue, pink, purple. I'm just using what I want. And like I've said, I haven't used this hot press that much. So y'all may see a bunch of mistakes. What am I saying? My middle name's mistakes. I am using a number 4. Round for this, and that's as high, probably as high as I'll go. And this is, I'm doing just a tad darker. Got my belly full and I'm sleepy. You may have to do that. You hear the chainsaw? Paper towel out, y'all. I'm doing good today. So, how's What would y'all like to see me do? Yes, the doctor is in here with me, so they being quiet at the moment. That's kind of scary. But if somebody walks up on the front porch, they'll tell me. And I'm sorry I'm not talkative today. I'm just kind of in a la-la mood. But, like I said, I've been aiming to do videos, and I've just, my life, I mean, it's just been crazy around here. And when I have had felt like doing videos, I'm having to do other stuff, so In some respects, I think the hot press is easier to do than the cold press. But in some respects, I don't think it is. I think it's your preferences. I mean, I'd say play with it and see what you think. Don't go by what I think about it. And it could be just me, because I've done cold press so much. And this is 100% cotton. I have hardly ever used one, you know, solid 100% cotton in all the, you know, I might have used like 50% or something. But it does remind me a lot of the Master Touch from Hobby Lobby, the mixed media, if that says anything. Okay, I'm going to use this blue. Okay, we got the hat done, and I'm pretty happy with it. I'm just gonna smooth some more out here. And, I I'm going to start on the base, on the bottom top of the base, and I put y'all on pause and went and done some things, so maybe that will help. So maybe I'll get my mojo back. Videotape with y'all doing this. I might be able to soak them. But I hate to. Thank you.
for a minute. God.
Okay, I've took a couple hours off, well, a couple days off, a day off. I've had stuff happen. So I'm coming back to this. We, going to revisit this and work on it today. Again, this is another new day. And I know y'all don't realize that, but I'm just telling it like it is. If anybody wants to know. And I'm just still using the same two combs. I've been using the Auburn and the Sienna. And I'm just going in, painting my boots, just like so. We should not get interrupted today, because I sent everybody that lives on this property a text saying that I'm videotaping. But that don't mean nothing. I promise you. And I'm just trying to make this to look like a boot. And it's not as easy as it looks, guys. Well, it's not to me. And I've got ants. Is anybody else having trouble with ants? I am using a 4-round. I think I need a bigger one. Then again, I don't know. I'm using a hot press paper. Oops, sorry. I had to make sure the mic was on. I am real bad about not turning the mic on or off. Okay, I am going in with the, I'm going to get number 6 round. It's 12. How do I say that? I don't know if I've got number 6 round. I think I just got to find it. I guess I'm going in with the number 12. And I'm just mixing the burnt umber in what I'm calling the burnt umber and the burnt sienna together to get the brown I want. And like I said, and add a little bit of this blue, just give me a little bit darker tint. Oh yeah. And I'm just kind of playing with my combs and all that fun stuff. Y'all know how it goes. I'm going to use the emblem on the soles of the boots. A bit darker than what I would on the top. Okay, I'm gonna make the top of this a little bit more brittle than the bottom. So I'm gonna add more of the burnt sienna. And I'm gonna try to just use 3 corners on this. Not sure if I can do this, but that's my goal. You know who you are. I'm adding just a little bit, just a tad of the blue with the burnt sienna to make that a little bit darker for the burnt sienna. Now the palette I'm using is calling this something different, but it's like on most palettes, it's burnt sienna. And y'all don't have to use the same thing as I'm using at all. This is a Pinterest image that I found. and downloaded it to my computer, and then just printed it off and traced it. What you think? This is about a 5x7 pad. Okay, I'm going back to with the number 2, 4, because I am going to do detail. Yes. Sorry, I am concentrating on what I'm doing. Uh-oh. There's gonna be a little bit of purple in that. Sick of ants. Hello. Welcome back to Angie's Creative Studio. It's been a few weeks since I've been working on this. I'm going to hopefully finish it this time. I've just had a lot of stuff going on in my life that I don't want to go into. But it's getting better. And I'm wanting to video again. And I'm going to finish this boot. I've messed up, as you can tell. And we are going just to finish this boot. And we'll do a background of some sort. Don't know what yet. We'll add a little bit of black to this. And so, how's everybody doing? What do y'all think about this virus going around? Is everybody stocked up on toilet paper? I know it's nothing to laugh about, because some people ain't. I want to travel, but I don't want to travel right now. Okay. And that's my clean, my dirty one, whatever. Today, I am going to take a Sharpie and I'm going to do like little stitches right through here before I get out of here. I don't need your help. And then I'm going to do just little stitches through here. Now, if you have a white gel pen, I don't. I aim to get one, and then I forget to get one when I order them. I run to Hobby Lobby. Would look probably better than the black. I'm just using what I've got. And I'm just, like I said, just making little stitches. You can try, you know, you can do however you want to do this. I just wanted to do this. Okay, I'm going to take a big round. And I am going in with a yellow oak for my background. And the reason I'm doing this is because of the fact that I screwed up. I just want it really lightly. And that's not as light as I want it. I am using an 18 round. Why I like the round is because you can spread it out or make it get into the little corners. This one's got a real nice point. It is a Hobby Lobby brand. I use a lot of Hobby Lobby. I've always used a lot of Hobby Lobby in my crafting, my art, all of it. And if you don't like Hobby Lobby, I'm sorry. I respect them for the religious stuff. But then again, I'm religious. I mean, I try not to. I do bring it on the channel. But I'm just going to act like that's supposed to be them. Does anybody else do that? And the block I'm using is a Paul something that I got. If anybody's wondering, I think I've explained it all earlier in the video. Like I said, it's been weeks. I know I've just kind of disappeared off the planet again. I've been feeling okay. It's just, I've just had a lot going on. We bought a Class A and we gutted it and working on it. Can't wait to get it done. To see it. So, with that being said, we are seeing it. Joey's sanding it now to get it ready for paint. We painting all the cabinets. We putting hardwood floors in it. We bought a new love seat and bed, queen size mattress for it. I mean, when you buy used, you kind of want your own stuff. Oh, I do. I mean, everybody's different, but what y'all think? Does this look good? I think it came out good, even though this is screwed up. But it'll be okay. Just something different. Okay, I'm going to take my pen and find it. And I'm going to sign Angie. I hope y'all enjoyed this video. Give us a thumbs up if you did. Subscribe to us. And stay tuned for more videos. We are going to start doing some card making. And I got a bunch of stamps the other day on Facebook Market. Or stamp ink pads. And I'm going to enjoy those. And we'll have some tutorials on inking and all fun stuff. And thank y'all for watching. Thank you for subscribing. And thank you for liking our videos. Have a blessed day. We'll catch you later. Bye.